Alright, so just add this at the beginning of the video. If this video seems like a little bit, like, lesser quality than usual, keep in mind that I was editing this video, recording this video, getting footage, getting music, all of this, in essentially, like, 10 minutes, because, you know, E3 is, like presentation after presentation, so it does build up after a while, but this is not my normal type of quality, so I still hope you enjoy this video. Okay, so I'm joined here with a friend of mine. Can I say like your Twitch name, I guess?
Sure.
Scrungis1, I'm pretty sure it is.
Yeah. Scrungis3, I think, but whatever.
So on my channel here, we were going to live stream it, but it was having like some connectivity problems, so we just thought, fuck it, whatever. But basically, the E3 briefing for Microsoft's or Xbox just went down, and honestly, like, I just kind of want to make like a recap video, and I don't know, Scrungis, what do you think? you good? Because normally you don't like Xbox that much. Like, you're more PlayStation, right?
I don't. But this year, there was this like, I mean, I guess the main thing was like Cyberpunk and fucking Elden Ring, which I was like fucking extremely excited for. I didn't think they were gonna show it here. And like, if those two games are like gonna be on Xbox like exclusive, and especially with this new like console, then I'm sorry, PlayStation.
I can't. Like, it was actually just like, I liked a lot of the things they did with it. I liked how it was like a lot of the thing. Like, there were some kind of cringy things, and I hate using that word, but like Funko Pop Gears and all that. But then like all the stuff of like, oh, Gears 5. Release date, Halo Infinite, more information, and then like you just like, let me, I honestly just, there was so much in that presentation I forgot a lot of it, but like there's a lot of indie shit on there, and like yeah, and like especially like, you know, Ori and Cyberpunk for sure. It's just like, it's really consider like, and everyone was saying that this one was so disappointing. Like, you have to be realistic though, because this is like the last year of E3 before like next year, where like Sony and Microsoft basically go fucking off with like presenting their new consoles. So Sony didn't even try. So I don't know. I feel like it was, a lot of people are saying that it's bad and it was boring, but I thought it was really good.
Yeah.
Just I guess just leave your opinions in the comments. I think that like, I don't know what else I'd ask for. Like, I especially loved that they actually showed off some of the new console, like, yeah, Project Scarlet. So they did the same thing with like the X when they revealed it, like in 2016, I think. So like, so next year we're gonna get like a whole bunch of information dumped on us, basically. So that's just hype for next year. But yeah. I don't know. I like, and also Game Pass too. Like, did you like? I might.
So much.
I don't know if I can like. I guess I could try to get Game Pass. I don't know if I can because, like, you know, subscriptions and all. But, like, just because Metro Exodus was included, that was an instant win. But, like, if you look at everything else that there, like, Forza Horizon's on there, Gears on there, like, a whole bunch of it, like, ID Xbox and, like, developer studios, like, all day one if you sign up for this. I think that, like, Game Pass honestly is worth it on its own. Just with all the shit that you get with it. I just don't really get why everyone felt so disappointed, but I guess everyone has their own opinions.
Yeah. In my opinion, they're all fucking wrong. Also, John Wick!
Oh yeah, right, John Wick came out on stage. It was pretty cool. So like, I don't know, if John Wick comes to your E3 briefing, like, you can't really compete with that. Like, the thing is that also, I highly doubt anyone else is going to beat Mike. Like, I'm not speaking, like, from a fanboy's perspective. I'm just saying, I mean, I think Nintendo has the best shot because they have, like, a whole bunch of shit coming out this year. But, like, I don't know. Nintendo's has always been really short, and they, especially after last year, I don't know what to expect. But I think that Microsoft really set, like, the bar high as hell this time. I don't know. Oh,
like, I'm a fucking PS4. I'm not even. Like, I had my Xbox 360. But oh my god.
Yeah, and I haven't really touched my Xbox One in a long time just because I've been playing a lot on PC, but like this new console, and especially because I think you're probably getting it, right, Scrungis?
Yes, of course. Especially, you know.
Oh, we forgot to mention Borderlands too.
Borderlands, yeah, of course.
Like, I don't, okay. I originally, like, this is more of like also a private thing, but like, remember like how I was saying I was not gonna get it on PC?
Yeah.
Because of Epic. I mean, after looking at the footage, I might consider it. It's just because, you know, not because it's on Epic, just because the game looks so fucking good.
Yeah.
But I don't know. They showed off a lot this year. Like, a lot more than I expected, considering, like, Sony dropped out entirely. I don't know. I think it was a good presentation.
Yeah.
Well, wait, what are you gonna say?
I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't know. I have no idea how Bethesda's gonna compare.
Oh, Bethesda's gonna be fun. Because, like, after... Like, they had a really good E3 last year, but after, like... Fallout 76. I just kind of want to see what they do.
It's gonna be really funny.
Yeah, the moment they bring up Fallout 76, it's just gonna be like
boom.
Yeah, everyone's gonna be screaming bro moment in the like theater.
Yeah. But what else is there gonna be? Outer Worlds.
Oh yeah, Outer Worlds was cool. That was like the first thing they showed, I think.
Yeah, one of the first things. Battletoads, I feel like, could be fun, especially since it's so fucking the first game, like, since all the way back in the fucking NES.
I will say, though, it did get a little bit annoying. Like, it only happened twice, but me and, like, Scrungis started, like, popping jokes about the whole Lego thing, because they showed a lot of, like, Lego and pop things, and it's just, like, nobody really cares, but I don't know.
Oh, my God.
And then, yeah, State of Decay was given some stuff. I'm just kind of, like scrolling
Ori
through. Ori, like, yeah, Ori. Yeah, Ori, for sure.
No Cuphead.
Oh, that's another thing, yeah. The Cuphead DLC.
Yeah, which sucks, but I feel like that's gonna come out this year or something.
Yeah.
Or next, I don't
But, yeah, I feel like they did a great job with, like, the, you know... I was about to say Battle Pass, but Game Pass and, like... I really like the value... Like, honestly, Game Pass is worth it on its own for me if you get Metro Exodus. Wait, if it's, like, on PC, does that mean that you get to play, like, through the Windows Store, or, like...
Windows Store, yeah.
Oh, okay. I mean, that's better than Epic from what I've... Because I think Windows Store has... Yeah, it has Xbox connectivity, so it's... Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
So, isn't Metro Exodus multiplayer?
No, I think it's single player, but Metro Exodus, from what I've heard, is like one of the best open world games you'll play. So,
yeah,
it sucks it's not on Steam.
Yeah,
that was
like Nintendo has what? It has Animal Crossing, Luigi's Mansion, Smash DLC.
Those are
excited to see those three.
Those are all big, but like
not as good as fucking.
Because, like, the thing is that Microsoft, they didn't, like, have as, like, they did have some of them, but they didn't have as, like, punching, I guess, and, like, hitting hard, like, IPs and stuff to show off, but they showed off, like, game after game after game after game, and eventually it just kind of builds up into, like, yeah, good luck beating that, at least in my opinion. Okay, so, hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to like and comment and subscribe and donate to my, please, I need the money. So, thank you. Help me.